Very interesting day was had today. It was a day that I found myself wrestling with the need to, I guess you could say, unleash the brave, reckless God within us all. There is an urge, an impulse towards what you might describe as the Dionysian, this desire for ecstatic obliteration, this desire for a relinquishing of the boundaries of the self. There is this itch for a kind of borderlessness and a kind of recklessness, if by reckless we mean complete romantic abandon, to fully let go of our inhibition in a way that is psychologically dangerous. And what I mean by psychologically, yes, right here, thank you. What I mean by psychologically dangerous is the willingness to face difficult things within us, the willingness to engage with our shadow and our psychic material. Thank you. And the willingness to allow ourselves to come apart, right? To create spaces in which we are allowed or able to come apart. That's no small picnic, because coming apart and falling apart is associated with the destruction that it leaves in its wake. And yet we grow from creating safe spaces for this need to extaculate and or ejaculate and utter ejaculations of amazement. To lose ourselves and to come apart is how we revivify, and it's how we grow. These are initiatory experiences. These are threshold states that we must continually cross. It's par for the course of our self-development to find spaces for ecstatic death practice and to literally fall apart and come apart. The breakdown to the breakthrough, as they say. Take your broken heart, turn it into art, because the alternative is unconsciousness, the default setting, the rat race, the constant gnawing sense of having had and lost some infinite thing, as David Foster Wallace said. We have no choice. We either express ourselves and marshal a response to the mystery, or in the words of Ernest Becker, we choke on our introversions. Because at the end of the day, we are gods with anuses. At the end of the day, we are gods and worms. And it is the wrestling match between these competing agendas, you know, the agenda of our divinity and the agenda of our mortality. And where these two intersect is through our expressiveness, the evanescent lightning bolts of meaning in the perceiver mind, in the perceiver's mind, that are made manifest into ecstatic vocalization and enraptured articulation. It is our poetry. It is the noble stand that we take in spite of our existential condition. It is this Dionysian need to express and say that here I am. And to render that into articulation is a death and a resurrection. It is a hanging of oneself on the cross. And I need to do that continually, every so often, as a kind of discharge. And if I don't discharge, I start accumulating the existential weight of repression and despair, which eventually eats you away. And so that's what today was all about, expressing that and becoming that and living into that. And I feel much better now. And I feel much better now.
Cheers.
Cheers.